Return on investment versus the payback method. Why do we need them? And what are the similarities and differences between these methods for investment analysis? Let's start with the central question that each of the methods tries to answer. For ROI, that question is, what percentage annual return do I get on my investment? For the payback method, the central question is, how many years does it take to recover the initial investment? Let's apply both methods to project A. Year zero, today, we have a cash outflow of $1,000. The brackets around the number indicate that it is a negative, a cash outflow. Over the course of the project, we have $1,600 worth of benefits, cash inflows in total, split evenly over 4 years of $400 each. Return on investment is the annual benefit of $400 divided by the investment of $1,000, so 40% ROI for 4 years. The payback period is 2.5 years. $400 of benefits in year one, plus $400 of benefits in year two, plus 6 months worth of benefits in year three for the final $200, at which point the total investment equals the total benefits. With stable annual benefits like in project A, ROI equals 1 divided by payback, 1 divided by 2.5 is 0.4 or 40%, and payback equals 1 divided by ROI, 1 divided by 0.4 is 2.5. Both return on investment and payback are simple to understand, but their ability to deal with a bit more complexity differs. What if we have multiple projects in our company that we want to force rank? We only have $1,000 of investment money to spend. Which project is financially speaking the most attractive? In total, for the full 4 years combined, each of the three projects has $1,600 worth of cumulative benefits, but the timing of these benefits varies. Applying the payback method can help. We already calculated the payback period for project A at 2.5 years. Project B has a payback period of 1.8 years, $600 in year 1 and $400 out of the year 2 benefits. Project C has a payback of 3 years, $200 in year 1, $300 in year 2, $500 in year 3. The payback method does a good job here. It recognizes that time is money. Earlier benefits are more valuable than later benefits. Project B is the most attractive. The unfortunate limitation of the payback method is that it is unable to help you select between projects with a different duration. For both Project A, with 4 years of annual $400 benefits, and Project D, with 5 years of annual $400 benefits, the payback period is 2.5 years, though Project D is obviously the most attractive project. But the payback method is unable to tell you that. We could compare the same three projects, A, B, and C, using return on investment. Remember that for ROI, the central question is, what percentage annual return do I get on my investment? The answer to that question for project A is 40% per year from year 1 through year 4. For project B, the answer would be 60% in year 1, going down to 20% in year 4. For project C, the opposite, 20% in year 1, going up to 60% in year 4. Now for most people, it is not intuitively clear which project to choose based on these ROI numbers. Should I go for the stable returns of project A, the decreasing ROI over the years of project B, or the increasing ROI over the years of project C? ROI doesn't seem to be a great decision tool here, as it doesn't really provide a clear answer. How about using average ROI then? Well, in my opinion, things just get worse with average ROI. As each of the projects has $1,600 cumulative benefits over 4 years, the average benefits are $400 per year for each of the projects. Average ROI would not help you to develop a preference for one project over the other, and fails to support your decision making. In summary, the central question for the ROI method is, what percentage annual return do I get on my investment? For the payback method, the central question is, how many years does it take to recover the initial investment? While they are both fairly easy to understand, each has inherent limitations. More sophisticated methods like net present value or internal rate of return may have to be applied to improve the decision-making process. I hope you enjoyed this short discussion of ROI versus payback. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up. On this end screen, there are a few suggestions of related videos you can watch next. Please subscribe to the Finance Storyteller YouTube channel. Thank you.